Welcome to PSM, Perfect Solution for Maths. Today we are going to learn the arithmetic progression, exercise 1.2 for the KSEB and exercise 5.2 for the NCERT. The three more questions, the next three questions, that is question number 14, 15 and 16. The question number 14 over here is, how many multiples of 4 lies between 10 and 250? Next question 15, for what value of n are the nth terms of two APs, that is 63, 65, 67 and 3, 10, 17, so on, are equal? And next question number 16, determine the APs whose third term is 16 and the seventh term exceeds the fifth term by 12. So one by one we will solve. Coming to the 14th question, in the 14th question you can see over here, the question is, how many multiples of 4 lie between 10 and 250? It is similar to the 13th question. So the first term and the last terms are very important in like this way questions. So what is the first term over here? So first term, more than 10, which is divisible by 4, which term it is, directly we can say that, because 4 table we know. 4 ones are 4, 4 to the 8, 4, 3 is a 12. So 12 is the number. See, 12 is the number greater than 10. So it have to take down the 12 as the first digit, the first number which is lying between the 10 to 250 and multiples of 4. So we can't take 8 because 8 is less than 10, because they have given between 10 and 250. So 8 we can't take. But we can take 12. So directly we can write down here 12. If you don't know the calculation, so what you have to do, the previous one, what I had told in the 13th question, how to solve. You have to take the 10, divide with the 4. 4 2s are 8, 2 remain. So what you have to do now? That 2 remain. So we have to take that 4. Then we have to minus the remainder. So how much it is? 2, and we have to take which number the have given lies between. So 10 it is, so we have to add the 10, so it will be 12. So like this way also we can do. The next number will be easy, because again we have to add 4 for this 12, it will be 16, and so on. What is the last term? It is very important now. So last term to find, very important. The last number what they have given here is 250. So take down that 250, divide with the 4. 4, 6 are 24, 1 is left, we will bring the 0 down, 4, 2 is 8, remainder is 2. So this is the thing, the important is this 2, remainder is very important. What I have to do now? We have to take the 250 number, the last digit what they have given. So 250 we have to take, in that we have to minus the remainder. So what is the left? 248. So last digit is 248. So like this way we have to do the to find the first term and the last term is very important. The second term is not so important because they have given the multiples of 4. So obviously the D value will be 4 only. But we will write the AP first. So for that purpose, 12 is the first number. Second is 16. So on, last one is 248. So next what we have to take is, which one is A1, which one is A2, that we have to write, that A1 is 12, A2 is 16, so on, that AN is 248. So A1 is nothing but A, that is 12, and A2 is 16, and AN is 248. So next we obviously need that D value, so D value is nothing but A2 minus A1, that is equals to, directly we can write down, 16 minus 12, that is equals to 4, or we can write down directly is equals to D is equals to 4, because here they have given multiples of 4. So what multiples they will give, that will be the our D value. Now we will apply the formula to find how many terms are there. Terms means nothing but we have to find over here N. So AN formula, AN is equals to A plus N minus 1 into D. So AN is nothing but 248. The last term is 248. Which one we have to find? So A value 12. Here we have. And N value we don't know. That only we have to find. The D value 4. We already found that multiple of 4. Next step is 12 we have to shift. Because it is a addition over there. So minus 12 is equals to n minus 1 into 4. 248 minus 12 is nothing but 236. That is equals to n minus 1 into 4. Now we have to shift which? The 4 we have to shift. So when we shift the 4, so here it is a multiplication, so it will be division. And the last one is n minus 1. And here one thing some of you ask, why we have to shift that multiplication first? Why we can't directly we can shift this minus 1 that side? Because Bodmas rule, you know, in Bodmas rule we have learned that first we have to solve the bracket. But in Bodmas rule, when you are shifting any number to the another side, we have to come from the right hand side to the left hand side when you are shifting it. So here subtraction is there, the first we have to shift the subtraction only, but that subtraction is inside the bracket. So bracket we have to shift last, so we can't send it directly. That is the thing over here. So now we will continue the calculation. So calculation is easy. 4 1s are 4, 5s are 20, 3 is left, 4 9s are 36. So our answer is nothing but here 59, that is equals to n minus 1. Now we can shift this minus 1 that side. So no need to write down in a bracket because nothing multiplication we have on this side. So 59, that minus 1 will turn into plus 1, is equals to n. So 60 is equals to the n value. So how many terms are there in between 10 and 250 which are multiples of 4? There are 60 terms. The final answer is very important. So write down, there are 60 terms, or we can write down multiples of 4 lies between 10 to, that is 250. That is your concluding statement. So this is very easy actually, but we have to understand the first, how to find the first term and how to find the last term. So it is easy thing to find. Coming to the 15th question. The 15th question, if you see it correctly, the thing is given is, for what value of n are the nth terms of two APs 63, 65, 67 and next one is 3, 10, 17 both are equal are given. Means the two APs are given. The first AP is over here 63, 65, 67 and so on is the first AP. So second AP they have given, I will write down on the right hand side now, 3, 10, 17, so on. There are two APs. So here you have to find, like this way if you continue at one place, that is here somewhere, the AP, I will take the AN, this term, the ANth term, and in this ANth term, two terms are equal it seems. Means if you will take this is 100, it will be 100 over here. So both the terms are equal. That is not 100, but I have taken as an example. Both are equal. So which is that n value? They ask you which is the n value when both the terms of this AP, the first AP and second AP, nth terms are equal. Then what is that n value how to find? So little bit tricky, yes, but we will solve very easily because it is not so tough. So first we will take the first AP. First AP is over here is this one. So A1 we have 63, A2 is 65 and A3. So on the last term we don't know, that we have to consider as AN because this AN and here this AN both are equal. So we will take this first and we will solve this and afterwards we will solve the second one. So first one while solving. So what is the A1 value? That is nothing but 63. So A2 value is nothing but the 65. So similarly AN value we don't know, that only we have to find. And we don't know the N value also, that is N value they have told you to find. See, find the value of N. So we will apply the formula now. AN is equals to A plus N minus 1 into D. So AN value we don't know, write down as it is. A value we know, that is first term, that is 63. So next one is n minus 1 into d. Now we have to find the d value also, that is very important to find. So d value is nothing but what? a2 minus a1. So a2 value is 65 minus 63. So obviously it is 2. So d value is nothing but what? 2. So we'll continue now. 63 we have to keep it as it is. We have to simplify how much it is possible. Till there we have to simplify. So an is equal to 63 as it is. So now we can't shift the 63 on the other side. We can't shift here. Why we can't shift here? Because here we don't know the an value. For that purpose we can't shift on the other side. So what we can do? This 2 I can multiply for this n, and this 2 I can multiply for this 1. So that we have to do it now. So multiply that 2 into n, how much? 2n minus we have, so put that minus. 2 into 1 is 2. So this is the thing. Now again we can continue further. So if we'll continue further, an remains as it is because we don't know. 63 minus 2, because the 2 constant thing we have, that's known thing, that 63 and 2 is known thing for us, so we can subtract that. 63 minus 2 is how much? 61 plus 2n I have kept as it is. So here you can see an is unknown, n is unknown, so again we can't simplify further. So we have to take this as what? Equation 1. So next we will move on to the next part, that is second AP that we have over here. That also we have to simplify as usual. What we have done previously, same thing we have to do. Here a1 is 3, a2 is 10, a3 and so on. An value we don't know and n value also don't know. So again we have to write the same thing, a1, a2 and an, and also we have to find the d value. So one by one we will solve. What is a1? a1 is nothing but what here? 3, that is considered as a. What we have done previously, the same thing we have to do on the right hand side. So remember that both don't get mix it up, because this AP is different and this AP is different. Don't mix them. A1 is different for this, but nth values are both are equal. This an is equal to the same. So we will continue. A2 is 10. An we don't know, that we have to find d value. We can find by a2 minus a1. A2 value over here is 10 minus 3, that is equal to 7. So d value is 7. Formula now. An is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Very important formula. Remember this. Don't forget this. An as it is. A value is, we know that 3 over here. N value is don't know. So n minus 1. D value we know that is 7. So same thing what you have done previously. Now we don't know this an value. So we have to write down that an as it is. So an I have to write down as it is. 3 we know that, write down as it is. But now we can't simplify now. So we have to take this 7 and multiply this n and 7 with the minus 1. So 7 into n is nothing but 7n. Minus we have, so minus 7 on the 7. So very importantly, last step of the second, for the second equation, an is equals to 3 we have, minus 7 we have. See, both of them have, doesn't have any alphabet, variables, so we can directly add them or subtract them. So 3 minus 7, which one is the greatest number? 7 is the greatest number having the negative, so negative sign. 7 is negative, 3 is positive, so greatest number is 7. 7 minus 3 is 4. So minus 4 is the thing. Again we have plus 7. And so this is our second equation. Why it is the second equation? Because here again two unknown things, an and n, are unknown things. Now the two equations we got, now we have to move further to find the n value. How to find that? For that purpose again we have to go for the question. Now we have to consider this first equation and the second equation. Question they have given. For what value of n? So n value you have to find. Are the nth terms are of the two APs are equal? Means an are equal in both the APs. Means this an is equals to this an, this side an. So these two things we have to remember. Means this an I will write down. Okay, I will write down the same ink only. An is equals to this an. Both the ans are equals to one another. So what is this an refers to? The equation 1, we can write on equation 1 is equals to equation 2. So equation 1, what we have, that is 61 plus 2n is equals to minus 4 plus 7n. Remember this. So next, what we have to do? We have to bring the known thing one side, unknown thing one side. So the 61 is the number, so I will write down the 61 here. And this minus 4, what we have, that I will bring on this side. So minus 4, when you will bring this side, it will become what? Plus 4. This side we left is 7n, that is positive. So I will write down 7n. This 2n we have to shift on the other side. The plus 2n will become minus 2n. So now we have to continue. 61 plus 4, how much? 65. That is equals to, in 7n minus the 2n, that is 5n. So we will continue further. So next one is 65 is equals to 5n. We have shift that 5 on the side, so it is multiplication. So when you shift, it will divide, that is equals to n value. So the calculation, we have 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5, means 1 is left, so 15 it is, 5 threes are 15. So what is the n value? N value is equals to 13. So this is our final answer, that only we have to find. Mean that in the first AP, that is 63, 65, 67, the 13th term, means this 13th term, A 13th term, and in this AP, second AP, the A 13th term, both are equal to one another. So we have to, finally we have to write that answer. 13th term of both APs are equal to one another. So this is our concluding statement. So 13th term is very important. How we have done? We have to learn it correctly. So an we found in the equation 1 and an we found in equation 2. Both of an are equal because we have not taken directly, because the question they have given, n terms of the APs are equal, nth terms, so we have taken and we have simplified. Nth term is nothing but in the equation 1, 61 plus 2n. In second term it is minus 4 and 7n, that we have taken. Then we have taken unknown thing one side and known thing one side. Then we have calculated, then we simplified, and finally we got that n value as 13. This is our 15th answer. So in the 16th question, when we will come, they have given that determine the AP whose third term is 16 and the 7th term exceeds the 5th term by 12. This is a question, looks like direct, and it is similar to some or 10th question in the same exercise. So what is that? So first, what we have given, they have given that we will write the third term of an AP is 16, they have given. So directly we can write down that third term. So A3 is 16. So first thing we have written. The second thing over here they have given is 7th term exceeds the 5th term by 12. Exceed I have given. In 10th question they have exceed. Exceed means what? More. So A7 is more than the A5. That is the thing they have given. How much more they have given? So A7 exceeds the A5, means is equal to A5 by how much? More means plus. By how much? 12. So A7 is equal to A5 plus 12. Exceed means more than the A5 by 12. So A7 is obviously is equal to A5 plus 12. This is the first thing you have to understand. By using this, we have to determine the AP, means we have to find the first term, second term, third term, and so on. We have to find, means they have not given here A value. See, A1 is not given, means A1 we have to find, nothing but A value we have to find. Second one, D value also given? No, they have not given the D value also. These are the two things we have to find in this question. So first, what they have given, from there only we will start. They have given A3. So A3 can be written in terms of what? A plus, how much D? That is 2D. is equals to 16. Those who don't know, again substitute the formula, an is equals to a plus n minus 1 into d, and substitute in that, that is the a3 is equals to n value is 3, so a plus n is 3 minus 1 into d, so a plus 2d. Directly you can write down like this way, or directly a3 is equals to a plus 2d also you can write down. So here one more thing, whether we know that a value and d value, don't know. So this one is, we can't continue further, so we have to take this as what, equation 1. So we have to move on to the second part. So second part is nothing but over here, the second thing what they have given. So second thing what they have given over here is a7. So a7 they have given, a7 we can write down same formula, you can substitute. So we can find that a7 can be written as a plus 1 less than the 7, that is 6d. So a7 can be written as a plus 6d. a5 can be written as a plus how much d, that is 4d, because 1 less than the 5. So that plus 12 they have given, same equation I have continued. A7 I have written a plus 6d, a5 I have written a plus 4d, 12 I have written as it is. Next it will be, we have to bring the unknown thing one side and known thing one side. So a is unknown, so we have to bring this a again on this side. So when you will bring that a on this side, what will happen? So here I will write down this a as it is. So when we will bring this a on this side, plus a it is, so it will become minus a. Next we have 6d, we have to write down that 6d as it is. We have to bring this 4d also this side. So 4 is plus, so minus 4d is equals to what is left on the right hand side. Only one thing is left over here is 12. So we have brought that a on this side and d also on this side. So next calculation, a minus a, both of them will get cancelled. So 6d minus 4d, both having the same variable, so that is d, so we can subtract them. The greatest number is plus, so 6 is the greatest number, so plus we have to write. In 6d we have to minus 4d, that is nothing but 2d, that is equals to 12. So d value we can find now very easily, d is equals to what, 12 we have to write, known thing is 2 for us, we have to shift this 2, it will not become minus, here you have plus, because it will not become minus, because in between 2 and d we have into, so it will divide. So into when we shift it will divide, so 2 ones are 2, 6 are, so d value we found as 6. So we found the d value. If you found the d value, we can substitute this d value in equation 1, that is 2a, a plus 2d is equals to 16. In that we can, how to substitute that value. So how, now we'll substitute that value in equation 1. Substitute d in equation 1, d means this d value in equation 1. So what is that, a plus 2d is equals to 16 is the equation 1, you can refer over here. So a value have to write down as it is, 2 as it is, d value is 6, that is equals to 16. Why have to substitute that d value, you may ask? D value you have to substitute to find what, a value, because we need a value and d value. D value already found, that is 6, so we have to find the a value. For that purpose we have to substitute that d value in equation 1. A plus 2 16s are, that is 12, sorry, 2 6s are, that is 12, that is equals to 16. So a is equals to 16. If you shift this 12 on the other side, it will become minus 12. 16 minus 12 is nothing but the 4. So a value we found as 4. So a value we found and d value we found. Now we have to find what they have given. Determine the AP. Determine the AP is nothing but we have to find the AP. That's all. So how, what is the first term? A1. What is the A1 value? That is 4. What is the A2 value? A2 value how to, we can find. How we can find the A2 value? So those who don't know, calculation. A1 is 4. A2 is nothing but what? A plus D. That is A is 4. D is 6. So 4 plus 6 is 10. The second term is 10. So A3. So nothing but again. So here plus 6 we have to add. D value have to add. Here also add that D value. 10 plus 6 is nothing but 16. Next will be 22, because 16 plus 6 is nothing but 22, that is A4, and so on. Like this way we have to find the AP. So the AP is 4, 10, 16, 22. Again, you can find or you can put the so on symbol. This is our final answer. This is easy, but understand the question. If you understood the question, very easy to solve. Here is a question for your work at home. The question A: for what value of n are the nth terms of two APs 4, 12, 20, so on, and 24, 30, 36, so on are equal? That you have to find as first question. Second one: determine the AP whose fifth term is 41 and the 12th term exceeds the 4th term by 40. So you have to determine the AP, you have to write down the AP. These are the two work at home for you. This is all about today's video. Please support my channel PSM First Aid Solution for Maths. Like, subscribe and share. See you in the next video. Till then, take care.